नमस्कार, वेलकम टू एवरीवन। आज हमारे बीच ये हम विदुषी रोहिणी भाटे जी के रिमेम्बरेंस में हमने ये लॉकडाउन पीरियड में प्रोग्राम रखा है। इसमें श्रीमती क्षमा भाटे जी, श्रीमती नीलिमा आध्याय, श्रीमती हसीता ओझा, श्रीमती कैरोलिन डसेल जर्मनी से, श्रीमती रुजुता सोमन और श्रीमती माधुरी जोशी जी आए हैं। इन सबको नमस्कार और वेलकम टू एवरीवन। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस प्रोग्राम रिमेम्बरिंग संगीत नाटक एकेडमी रत्न अवार्डी विदुषी रोहिणी भाटे जी। और सबसे पहले वी वुड लाइक टू सी पार्वती वंदना बाय विदुषी रोहिणी भाटे जी।
क्या बात है, बहुत अच्छा।
क्षमा भाटे जी, मैं चाहूंगा कि आप अभी रोहिणी भाटे जी के डांस ट्रेनिंग पीरियड के बारे में, उनके गुरुओं के बारे में कुछ थोड़ा सा बताएं, सबसे शेयर करें कुछ।
पहले तो सबको नमस्कार। जयवंत जी, आई एम वेरी ग्रेटफुल टू यू फॉर ब्रिंगिंग इन दिस टीचर अबाउट रोहिणी जी, माय गुरु जी। एंड Just now I was watching her and it's an emotional moment for me. But of course, and you see the vibrancy in her dance, which comes across the screen as well. So it becomes very emotional. You go back to all the years you have spent with her. But of course, I would like to tell you about her training. She learned from Pandit Maharaj Kalyan Purkar and also from Pandit Lachhu Maharaj, and a long training with both the gurus. First, Maharaj Kalyan Purkar, when he was in Lucknow in Marist College. Roniji was in Pune. You can imagine how difficult it must have been, because those years when I think it was 58, 59, it wasn't as to travel as easy as it is now. So she would travel by train, no direct train. So she has to go to Jhansi, then Lucknow, and very cold, the floor getting very cold, her feet getting frozen. But she was one determined person, and she learnt there by going from Pune to Lucknow. Afterwards, she learnt from Guru Lachhu Maharaji in Mumbai. And Lachhu Maharaji's training mostly at that time was from Jaipur Gharana, long and very intricate compositions. Also, लयकारी उनका लयकारी में वो बहुत से दस थे मोहनराव जी और रोहिणी जी भी. मगर एक बात का जिक्र मैं करना चाहूंगी, देर वॉज नो टेप रिकॉर्डर्स देन एंड रोहिणी जी वुड रिमेम्बर एवरीथिंग शी लर्नड एंड आई डोंट नो हाउ एंड शी इवन आफ्टर 10 इयर्स वी गॉट टू लर्न एवरीथिंग व्हाट शी लर्नड देन. Very intricate and very, very important, I would say, compositions. Even today, they stand with the same importance in Kathak. Then she started learning from Pandit Lachhu Maharaji in Mumbai. Again, from Mumbai, Pune, every weekend. And it was more, of course, it was Lucknow Gharana. Lachhu Maharaji's forte was bhav and nuances. And Roniji learned that. But again, a person wanting to learn from two different people, Mohanravji was very strong on Tatkar. And Lachhu Maharajji would say, no, no stamping of the feet, I can't say, I was there. And Roniji's dance was very vibrant. Pair mein taakat, josh, tadaf. And here, Lachhu Maharajji telling her ki soft karo, pair ki awaaz na ban paaye, bas ghumru bajao. Magar Rohini ji being Rohini ji, she mastered both the techniques, and you can see a confluence in her style, Lachhu Maharajji as well as Munrao ji. Afterwards, again, when Munrao ji was at the NCPA, she again learnt from Maharaj ji a couple of compositions very important, which I think she danced many times, like Preeti Kare Kahun, Sukhna Layo, then Aise Ram, Jagat Hitkari. So very, very, how would I say? I must say that these compositions, I have seen only Rohini ji dancing. So very Bindadin ji's, Surdas's, but very important compositions and a lot of detail for emotion. And about Parvati Kumar Masterji, I have only heard from her, because by the time I went to her, she wasn't learning from Parvati Kumarji. But she again had a long training, and she would say that since she was a Sanskrit scholar, and so was Parvati Kumarji. So Sucheta Tai, she told me that Rohini ji was the first one who took that Marathi, which Parvati Kumarji worked on, the Marathi Sarfoji Raja's compositions. Rohini ji took it to Parvati Kumarji. So, and Parvati Kumarji's work started, the Marathi compositions. हाँ जी
हाँ अभी आई वुड नाउ रिक्वेस्ट नीलिमा जी आप कुछ उनके म्यूजिक का ट्रेनिंग के बारे में कुछ बताइए, उनके म्यूजिक के गुरुज, संगीत में उनका भी काफी रुचि और उन्होंने काफी संगीत सीखा।
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल नमस्ते जैवन जी एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर हैविंग मी स्पीक अबाउट माय गुरु एंड नमस्ते टू एवरीबॉडी। ड्यूरिंग गुरु रोहिणी जीज ग्रूमिंग विद हर ग्रेट डांस गुरुज, शी हैड रियलाइज्ड दैट learning the allied arts for dance was extremely important, and she equipped herself to become a complete and self-sufficient dancer. For this, she learned from the famous vocalist Pandit Basantrao Deshpande ji, from whom she got the training of Indian classical music or singing for about 8 to 10 years. And this enabled her to delve deep into the complexity and beauty of Indian classical music. Before that, she also had training from the music director and critic Pandit Keshav Rao Bhoye ji in Pune. And during her stay in Lucknow at Bhatkhande College of Music, she got guidance from two brothers of Sahaswan Gharana, Ustad Ghulam Sabir Khan and Ustad Ghulam Ghaus Khan. Also in Mumbai, she got training, rigorous training, theoretical training from Pandit Ramkrishna Bua Joshi, who was a disciple of Pandit Vishnu Digambar Paluskar. So this whole training period then resulted into a great musical repertoire created by Guru Rohini ji for Kathak. And here I also must mention the other aspect. This dance is a composite art form, and along with music, literature also is an most important part of dance. So I remember her always speaking with great respect about her teachers in school and college for Marathi and Sanskrit. I can say, just as Samaji mentioned just now, that in all her creative journey, she didn't need help of anybody to decipher the Sanskrit text that she used, and she used it many times. So also during, again, her stay in Lucknow, she made very passionately use of the library there, because in Kathak we used the Hindi language and its dialects like Vraj language and so on. So she wanted to master the language also. And this resulted in another repertoire, her lyrical compositions. So I would say that a kind of self-grooming also was there, and she insisted on becoming a complete and self-sufficient dancer. So all these compositions, which are musical and lyrical, are a contribution of her to not only the field of dance, but I think they are a great composition contribution to the field of music as well as the field of literature.
Thank you, Neelima ji. Abhi, now we would see a video where Rohini ji is sharing her thoughts and a little bit of the performance. So, थोड़ा हम उनका उनके विचार और उनका performance देखते हैं.
In India, there are about 7 classical dance styles, and one of them is Kathak, which I have been studying for all these number of years. Kathak has evolved out of an ancient tradition of storytelling. And the storytellers were attached to temples in the north of India. It hails from the north. And it has, undergone so many cultural upheavals that it has emerged as a now complete dance with a little alien influences also. But while coming to the stage, it has evolved out beautifully into a perfect dance, having virtuosity, technique and complexity of rhythms, and even deeply expressional dances. It is different from other classical dances in this way that it is a bit secular in its presentation, though it is spiritual and based on real tradition, it is free in treatment. It has got this freedom of using many contemporary themes even. So, and one more speciality of Kathak is that it has got a lot of scope for improvisation on the stage. The influence does not seem as a separate aspect of the dance, you see. But from devotional dancing, it came to the court and it became a form of entertainment in the Mughal courts, in the Muslim courts. That was the difference really. And a competitive spirit came into it. Actually, there was one contribution through this happening to the Kathak dance, that because being competitive in the courts, it also developed the elements of virtuosity and speed and high technique, you see. I think the purpose of dancing was devotion, dedication to the gods once upon a time in ancient times. Mm-hmm. It became just entertainment and as a visual. And now it has come back to its having its aesthetic purpose, you see. It is sort of enlightenment now, not just entertainment. I feel dancers are not entertainers.
Hari sut priti kari jal sut so samput mahi gayo samput mahi gayo priti kari kahu sukh na
kabhi. I would request Madhuri ji, aap kuch bataye Rohini ji ke performances as a performer.
Jaroor. Namaskar Jaivan ji. Aur aap sab ko ji. Ha, mera itna saubhagya raha hai ki maine Rohini ji ko 25 saal Surat Sangat ki.
Kya baat hai.
To 25 saal mein ना जाने कितने परफॉर्मेंसेस, ना जाने कितने प्रैक्टिसेस, और सब में वो मेरे सामने आती रहती थी. और अभी जो जो हमने पीसेस देखे, रिकॉर्डिंग जो देखी, तो वो सब मेरे आज मेरे मन में इतना मेरा मन भर आया है, इतनी यादें हैं उसकी. क्योंकि एक तो लाइव म्यूजिक होता था, ये बड़े सौभाग्य की बात है, क्योंकि लाइव म्यूजिक में हम उनके साथ ही स्टेज पे होते थे और वो सब हमें देखने को मिलता था. रिकॉर्डेड म्यूजिक में बिल्कुल ये नहीं पॉसिबल था, लेकिन वो लाइव होने के कारण हर बार उनका जो जो भाव प्रदर्शन होता था, उनकी जो लयकारी, क्योंकि दो सेक्शन होते हैं डांस में, एक तो नृत्य का और नृत्य का, तो वंदना होने के बाद जो ताल का पक्ष होता था उसमें भी उनका बहुत सुंदर परफॉर्मेंस मुझे देखने को मिलता था. और उसके बाद फिर से हम अभिनय पक्ष में जाते थे. तो इन सब बातों में मुझे हमेशा लगता था कि उनकी डांस की तरफ देखने की सोच विचार, उनकी परफेक्शन की जो आस थी, वो उनके डांस में जो नज़ाकत होती थी, क्योंकि अभी लास्ट में हम शायद देखने वाले हैं ऐसे राम, ये एक पद वो करती थी. तो एक ऐसे राम में राम होते थे सीता माई, लक्ष्मण, जटायु, शबरी, ना जाने कितने कैरेक्टर्स उसमें आ जाते थे और वो हम सब देख पाते थे. तो तो उनका वो परफॉर्मेंस की जो ऊंचाई थी वो देखकर मैं अचंभित हो जाती थी। और इन सब में कथक को मायने रखते ही सब हो जाता था, यानी कभी ही वो कभी भी कथक की ऊंचाई से वो बदला नहीं वो डांस, और ये मुझे बहुत आनंद की बात लगती है। ऐसे बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट भी हैं अभी उनके, और कुछ क्लिप्स भी हम देखेंगे, कुछ देख सकते हैं। लेकिन मैंने एक दौर ऐसे उनके साथ गुजारा है कि सुबह 9 बजे उनका रियाज शुरू हो जाता था, और मैं किसी स्कूल में काम करती थी तो उसी समय मैं उनके साथ प्रैक्टिस के लिए जाती थी। तो वो जो रियाज होता था उसमें उनकी लगन जैसे मानो रियाज पूजा थी उनके लिए। तो कौन से भी दिन ऐसा नहीं हुआ कि अगर वो आउट ऑफ इंडिया और आउट ऑफ पूना नहीं है तो कि उनका रियाज शुरू नहीं है। तो ये बात मुझे अब लगता है कि मैंने जो जो बहुत सुंदर परफॉर्मेंसेस देखे उन सब में वो रियाज मायने रखता है, और उस रियाज की नींव उस परफॉर्मेंस को बहुत सुंदर बनाती थी।
धन्यवाद माधुरी जी। अब हम आगे बढ़ते हैं और मैं चाहूंगा शमा जी आप कुछ बताएं रोहिणी जी के परफॉर्मेंसेस के बारे में।
एज अ परफॉर्मर आई वाज वेरी वेरी फॉर्चुनेट, आई वाज विथ हर ऑन द स्टेज डूइंग परंत रेसिटेशन ऑफ बोल्स, एंड she was one person who was very vibrant on the stage. Agility bhi thi aur thehrao bhi tha, ekdam shant bhi aur quick bhi, dono cheez matlab jo contrasts hote hain wo dono unme sammilit the. Aur mujhe ye yaad hai ki improvisation wo takkar mein improvisation, bhav mein improvisation, and she could enthrall the audience. सब लोगों को जिसको बोलते हैं कि पकड़ के रखती थी। मैं एक किस्सा जरूर बताना चाहूंगी कि एक बार हम लोग गए थे होमी भाभा ऑडिटोरियम में उनका प्रोग्राम था, और एक गायत्री जी करके भरतनाट्यम पहले था बाद में रोहिणी जी, तो उनका हो गया सेकेंड हाफ में रोहिणी जी का था। तो ऐसे लगा कि थोड़ा लेट तो होता ही है ना हर चीज, तो लेट हो गया अभी लोग रुकेंगे कि नहीं, मगर जैसे उनका शुरू हो गया जो भी जिसका भी मुंह बाहर के तरफ था सब टर्न हो गए, सब आके बैठ गए, पूरी पूरा उनका प्रोग्राम रुके रहे देखते रहे। एक रसीलापन था उनमें, भीगापन था, आई डोंट नो हाउ टू से इट इन इंग्लिश सो आई हैव टू से इट इन हिंदी, कि एक भीगापन उनके हर चीज में, लय करो, हंस करो, भाव करो, एक भीगापन। कभी भी उन्होंने लय को भी रूखेपन से नहीं देखा, भाव को भी नहीं रूखेपन से देखा। तो ये चीज मुझे लगती है कि उनका जो कथक के प्रति प्यार था वो झलकता था उनके नाच में। तो दैट्स द बेस्ट थिंग आई रिमेम्बर अबाउट हर परफॉर्मेंस।
क्या बात है। तो अभी मैं रुजिता जी से रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि आप कुछ बताएं रोहिणी जी के परफॉर्मेंसेस के बारे में।
सबको मेरा नमस्कार एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर कंसिडरिंग मी इन दिस ब्यूटीफुल कॉन्वर्सेशन अबाउट माय गुरु। जैसे अभी शमा जी ने बात की, लाइक रसीलापन, भीगापन एंड कंप्लीटली डेडिकेटेड टू हर पैशन। सो वही लाइक मुझे लगता है आई स्टार्टेड वॉचिंग हर परफॉर्मेंसेस व्हेन शी वॉज ऑलमोस्ट 60 years old, एंड आई फील रियली फॉर्चुनेट टू सी मैनी ऑफ हर परफॉर्मेंसेस ट्रैवलिंग विथ हर एंड मैनी रिहर्सल्स एज वेल आई हैव सीन, एंड अमेजिंग एनर्जी शी हैड, लाइक शी वॉज अ वेरी स्ट्रांग वुमेन। एंड यहाँ मतलब हर एक परफॉर्मेंस अभी भी आंखों के सामने ऐसे ताज़ा है, इट्स देयर इन माई हार्ट। एंड यहाँ पे मैं दो परफॉर्मेंसेज ज़रूर मैंशन करना चाहूँगी। एक तो जस्ट फ्यू डेज बिफोर हर हार्ट सर्जरी, And one performance exactly after 3 months after her heart surgery. She was about 72 years old at that time. And she performed for 2 hours. And what a vibrant performance it was. So energetic. सब उनके कंसल्टिंग डॉक्टर्स फर्स्ट रो में बैठे हुए थे. दे वर इन ऑ एंड वी विटनेस्ड दैट वन ऑफ देम बो डाउन एंड सेड यू आर अ मिरेकल. सो आई वुड लाइक टू एड टॉप ऑन टॉप ऑफ इट दैट शी हैड गिवन स्ट्रिक्ट इंस्ट्रक्शंस टू एवरीवन नॉट टू टेल एनीथिंग अबाउट इट टू एनीवन. So actually, she was really a very strong lady, and she never had any excuses in her life, and she never looked for any sympathy. So I always take that energy with me whenever I'm like emotionally there are ups and downs in my life. So I really just remember my guru, and I just go ahead. And really, I feel she's like a powerful flowing river. She will go where she will, and just she will reach to her destination prepared just to be herself, just herself. So see, she's really inspiring for all of us. That's what I can say about her. Just I carry her energy with me.
Yeah. So. Yeah. Now I would like Ashita to tell us about Niji and performances. Ashita ji?
Oh, me.
Yeah.
Okay. Namaste, Jaivan ji. I'm very proud to be her disciple and trained under her. About her performance, I would say that she lived her dance, and so she lived her performance. So either it's Sadadas, Sadidas, or Trital, or Sadisat, either it's Gat or Thumri, every movement she lived. So that is her identity. And so the vibrancy, energy, she was so dynamic. And so everything just transformed. Since she lived her movement and dance, there was no cultural background, no cultural conflict, no gender conflict, no age conflict, and her dance became universal. She created this huge repertoire of nritya and nritya aspect. So it is a huge contribution to Kathak world. I was always, for Nritya aspect, I would say, I would just mention a comment from Birju Maharaj ji, that once she performed probably in Ahmedabad, and he was in the audience, and he came spontaneously on the stage, and he said that, aisi laikari na kabhi hui hai, na kabhi hongi. So I think this is it. To have a compliment from such a guru like Birju Maharaj ji. Though I was always drawn to the Abhinay aspect of it. And I was, as a student, I was always wondering that she is not something ordinary. She is divine person. And all her creation, she has some source of divine where she is. Her creations are coming. So at what level she is awakened that her dance is so impactful. So I would like to give some instances that when she performed Mirabai's bhajan, Tanik Hari, Chitta Bojji Mori Or, and it is still in my mind. So I saw that 30 years ago. And Mirabai says that my love, my intense love towards Krishna is exactly same as a chatak bird who is in burning summer waiting for that drop from Swati Nakshatra. And her, that chatak bird, her beak the way it opened and her breathing of the movement of her chest, I still exactly remember the same. So I was always searching that what level of awakenment she has and how she has it. And in that process, I met her again after, say, 15 years. And again, she said that, Hasita, see what different new compositions I created. And then she first started with Nahi Aaye Ghanashyam, Baithi Soche Brijadham, Suna Mero Dham Nahi Aaye Ghanashyam. So very intensely she went into the subject. And as soon as she is done, she went to the other composition and she said, Tori main na manungi jhuthi batiyan karat. So completely different subject, different naika, but the way she moved as if that this emotion is over, you go into your compartment. Now next emotion, I employ you and now you do your work. So she was so objective and away from the self. And I thought that was huge progress. And the third stage is even interesting, that once I was in Bombay with her, and she was saying that Mr. Jathar, her husband, used to tell her that, why do you make everything so complex? Why can't it be simple? And so brilliant as she is, she must have thought that what is being simple? So it's not like diluted version of you. But like Steve Jobs says that your goal has to be very simple. So his goal was just a communication. Everyone in the world should come together and communicate. That's it. But what goes under it, the hard software and hardware, the customer user should not know. So I think she searched herself so much, and then whatever is required, and that is like vikar mukta, then only you can connect fully to the search of God. And then she comes to choreography of Vrindavana Dhamani Ko, where she admires the simplest being, simplest things of the world. And that is the truth. And where there is no mudras, no postures, no poses, no rhythm, nothing. Just Madhuri's pure song and Rohini Bhatte's pure dance. And I thought that's where the liberated performer, where the pure dancer and pure dance came together. And that is the performance for me, the highest state of performance and performer is Rohini Bhatte.
Thank you for sharing your thoughts. Now we will request Neelima ji to share her thoughts. Neelima ji, aap kuch Rohini ji ke performance ke bare mein kuch.
In her whole journey, she was thinking and exploring and defining what dance is. And there was a stage when she had written a beautiful passage where she said that, what is dance if not a prayer? Dance is a prayer. And that still stands. But as she went on and towards the final definition that she came to, she said that 100% awareness of your every particle of your body, your throbbing body, is dance. Awareness, whole body is dance. And she used to come to the stage with such radiant awareness the radiance of which used to fill the whole space on the stage, not only fill but take charge of the space as well as charge of the minds of the viewers. That it was the most engrossing experience for everybody. Many times when I watched her performance sitting in the audience, what happened to me was I got an experience of a kind of elation, sheer joy that used to stay with me for days together after one performance. I think this sheer joy is the aim of any art form. And no matter what she performed, any subject that she chose or any emotion that she depicted or any taal she presented, it didn't matter. But everything ultimately used to reach such brilliance of her intellect, beauty, spirituality, everything, that it used to resonate in everybody's mind. May the viewer be a dancer who can understand everything or a layman. So her dance used to transcend the boundaries of everything and just become spiritual. Just everybody used to get drawn into it. Thank you.
Now I would request Caroline to let us know her thoughts about Rohini Ji's performances.
Thank you, first of all, for inviting me into this wonderful group of speakers who are all senior in art to me. And I would like to talk about when I did a documentary film about Rohini Ji. She once said in an interview that 100% perfection is another name of God. And she said, this you can never reach. You are not God. But on each level of your dance, you can seek a sort of perfection. And not only in dance, but you should also seek the perfection in your writing, in your thinking, even in your manners, in your rehearse. So on each level, you should try to perfect yourself. So when she danced or rehearsed, so nothing less than perfection was her goal in dance and in presenting her dance. And I always felt that it showed so much in her performances that it was not done to show off or present herself, but it was so pure and so authentic. And that was really what was so touching, and how Nilima said she really reached out to the audience because it was just 100% done for the art itself. And she would not even expect anything for that. She didn't do it for fame or for a name or for earning much money. She just did it for the art form, and she would never stop. She always went on. So when I was in the West, and sometimes maybe I felt alone being here and not having a teacher here for a long time. So whenever I felt low in spirit, I just thought, her spirit was never to give up. You just go on every day. And that is what I learned from her for dance, but also for life.
Thank you. Thank you, Caroline. Yeah. अभी शमा जी, मैं कुछ वो सिल्वर जुबली प्रोग्राम के कुछ फोटोज पहले दिखा रहा हूँ. ये जो
प्लीज दिखाइए,
जो सिल्वर जो सेलिब्रेशन हुए थे, ये हैं और ये. एंड और अब मैं एक होरी का वीडियो दिखाना चाहूंगा. मतलब कैसे उनसे भी इंस्पिरेशन, उनके काम से इंस्पिरेशन कैसे हुआ है, तो ये वीडियो देखेंगे, फिर हम चाहेंगे कि आप कुछ बताएं हमें. हाँ हाँ ठीक है, आप बात.
A little bit about Silver Jubilee. it was, of course, everybody knows it was 25 years, but I feel that I would like to say that in a place like Pune, where she had to really convince the parents and the students to come to class when she started, because Pune had a lot of taboo. So her work in Pune is like Rukmini Ji, Rukmini Devi Arundel, that she almost convinced everybody that dance is an art form, which is, as everybody has been saying, for God, as a form of devotion. And that is the reason Pune got, now you see the vibrant dancing in Pune, because of her hard work for so many years. So in when we celebrated 25 years, she had a novel idea. For a whole year, she invited many dancers from different styles.
Okay.
So Pune had never seen Odissi before. Okay. Pune had never seen Mohiniyattam before, which she, so Pune hadn't seen Sachin Shankarji. So she brought many people, and Pune actually got to know there are so many styles, not just one or two, but 7-8 dance styles, and so much of hard work is going on in. And she invited, I remember, Rita Ji, Rita Devi Ji, of course, her both gurus, Lachu Maharaj Ji, Monrao Ji, Sachin Shankar Ji, Kanak Reli Ji. So everybody was there. And for the finale, she had 2-3 days festival. I remember 2-3 things. One was Malhar. And Malhar is a significant, I think, choreography, because in that she used a lot of abstraction. Normally in Kathak, everybody would show the raindrops, some gestures, some mudras, some positioning. But we all danced, and our only feet were seen, and they were raindrops, and we were jumping like like that. And it was so wonderful, I can tell you, the abstraction. I hadn't seen actually that kind of abstraction before. This is 1972. And the picture you saw, Binda Kahe, that both her gurus were there. I should say all three were there. Lachu Maharaj Ji was there, Monrao Ji was there, and Vasant Rao Ji was there. Vasant Rao Ji actually sang for her, "Main to khelungi unhi se hori." And you said about hori. So this was the first hori I had ever seen Rohini Ji doing, "Main to khelungi unhi se hori." Her own expression, a personal individual expression, a personal experience. And she had set one more, which was Jasoda Ke Lal Khele Hori, and that was a group composition. We danced that. She had used intricate rhythms like Dhamar, Japtal. She had interwoven it into that Jasoda Ke Lal Khele Hori. So when I was composing my own composition at the time of my Silver Jubilee now, so I thought of Hori. I thought of Hori. And then I put all the things I think I'd learned at that time. I wouldn't say I tried. I would say I tried to put things, because you know, you don't know when you imbibe things, and they come to you, they surface, and then you try and combine. So I had learned many kavits. She used to compose kavits. I can't compose a kavit, but I borrowed it. So I have composed it with a personalized Hori and a group Hori together. So now, if you would like to show the clip.
Yeah, yeah.
May I request you to show the clip now? Thank you.
We'll see.
खेलो नंदलाल संग रंग भरी लाल संग रंग भरी छाए अबीर गुलाल के बादल छाए नाचत गावत सब जन आए अबीर गुलाल के
अबीर गुलाल के बादल छाए
नाचत गावत
So you see the space activation, the colors,
yes,
the movement, and the music.
Yeah.
That's what we learned from her.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And now I will request Vijita ji to tell us about the choreography aspects of Rohini ji.
It's really difficult what to pick up. There are so many beautiful things I have learned from her, like poetry composed by her, the kavitas, then so many odd number tals which are complete in its structure, like in a margam, and so many beautiful aspects of abhinaya and thematic compositions. There are so many. It's like a full bloom flowers and which to pick. It's really a big task. But I remember, like Hasita Tai was telling about the dohas and the treatment. So I would like to mention especially about the doha, which is a very unique aspect of abhinay in Kathak. And it doesn't have as support of any tal or theka like Hasita Tai mentioned. And it's really very difficult to perform abhinay effectively when there is no support of tal and theka. So she really taught us a very unique a feature, the very amazing technique of abhinaya. That is the speed variation technique while performing sancharis or emoting the sancharis and very minute expressions as well. So here I would mention one doha. Again, I feel really very fortunate that this and very honored that this doha was composed on me. And in that doha, there is a description about Naika's, that heroine's beautiful eyes, yet mischievous. And the poet says the sun or moon or even a thief can be hidden, but her eyes can't be hidden. So there is one line, Chandra chhipe amavasai. So she had shown that journey of the full moon, that is a Purnima, till the Amavasya, the lunar phase of new moon. She composed that so beautifully with the technique of that speed variation, lay kam zyada karna, abhinay ki. So that is really very unique and very subtle way she composed, like Chandra, full moon. Then and Amavasya. So it was really amazing technique and the way she composed, how she can think such minute things. And there are so many things to tell about these aspects, but I would like to show some glimpses of this Doha if we can. I was really fortunate to learn many compositions personally from her, one-on-one. So I really remember each and every Doha, and it's very close.
Okay. We'll see it.
Thank you, Jaivanji. And all these aspects of Abhinay, the deep thinking and this minute, very subtle expressions and everything which we have learned, it can be applicable to the compositions which we compose ourselves. So that helps us so much. And even I would like to talk about one group choreography, that is a thematic choreography, Kathputli. Actually, I'm really fortunate to be a part of many of her choreographies. And this is really very special, I think. And all are really very special. But each choreography was really very unique in terms of a subject, the treatment, and I would say they were relevant they are relevant in all the areas, I would say. So it were composed through that vision. So she was actually a visionary. And so this Kathputli, meaning akanksha, the aspiration, it depicts an attempt of soul searching of a woman, strangled in wanted, unwanted bonds of society, rituals, ancient cultures, family demands, and so on. And she presented this subject with a perfect symbolism of Kathputli, that is a puppet, and with a beautiful blend of the traditional movements and some movements she invented. And I would say this is the great contribution to the vocabulary of the movements of the Kathak. A very special movement which she used in the Nritta part of the Kathputli, that is, it means uthna. So like I can interpret like this. So it is relevant and such a meaningful movement, and there were so many meaningful movements she invented, and this is really a great contribution to the vocabulary. And and mainly I think this thought is so unique, and it's relevant now as well, and it can be a story of any soul of a mankind who is struggling for the any kind of a freedom. So it's, and of course it is really very close to my heart, because when she revised this choreography, she chose me as a main character, main role in that composition. So not only because of that, but really I feel this is very meaningful, and really fortunate to be part of many of her choreographies. So if we can show some glimpses of that choreography, that would be great.
कठपुतली गुस्से से बोली, कठपुतली गुस्से से बोली, ये धागे क्यों हैं, क्यों हैं ये धागे मेरे पीछे आगे, इन्हें तोड़ दो, इन्हें तोड़ दो। मुझे मेरे पांव पर छोड़ दो, मुझे मेरे पांव छोड़ दो, सुनकर बोली और कठपुतलियां कि हाँ, बहुत दिन हुए हमें अपने मन के छन छुए।
So that's it. Thank you so much.
अभी मैं रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा नीलिमा जी से कि हमने डांस पर बातचीत किया, हमने उनके म्यूजिक पर ट्रेनिंग पर बातचीत किया, लेकिन उनका पोएट्री में भी काफी रुझान था, और पोएट्री और उसमें से जो भी अभिनय वगैरह, तो मैं चाहूंगा आप कुछ बात करें।
जी, जैसे कि आपने पोएट्री के बारे में कहा, और एक दो और भी आपने सजेस्ट किए थे कि उनका सब्जेक्ट का चॉइस किस तरह से होता था, या विच ताल शी चोज फॉर व्हाट पर्पस। सो आई थिंक आई विल वीव ऑल ऑफ दिस टुगेदर एंड ट्राई टू आंसर इन अ कॉम्पैक्ट वे। So about, she had tremendous interest in poetry, and I would like to categorize them, this answer, in three parts. The first part is where she used someone else's poetry. In this region, there are so many poets of whom she used the poetry. She used Sanskrit poetry from the Vedic Kal. Then she used poetry like of Kalidas, and then Madhyakalin Hindi poets, and then Marathi poets, poetry of German, French, Chinese, all languages. So this was a poetry from like the first days of human possibility of making a poetry to the most recent times. Like you just saw one of the poetries that you chose in Kathputli. So this is a vast reading first of all, and then taking up subjects and making use of them. Here I would like to mention a very important thing, which is whichever poetry she chose a poem and worked on it, her visualization, especially her interpretation, was used to be very much of her own. If I just take Kathputli, then the last line says, this Kathputli the puppet tries to free herself from all the unwanted bonds. But then taking on the freedom is very difficult for a woman. And hence the last line of the poem says that, ye ichha mere man mein kyun jagi? And that is where the poet has left it there. But Guru Rohini ji changed it just towards the end. The puppet is trying to go back to the rest of the puppets and all. But then she realizes that ye ichha mere hi man mein jagi. So she is glad that it is her who could think of freedom first of all. Then getting there is another thing. But this kind of positivity was prevalent in her choreographies. Another example I would like to give was a poem which said that main udaas hu. Person who is pessimistical is saying this, that main udaas hu, and that is the total mood of it. But when she created the choreography by taking this poem, she chose two characters, one who is udas, who is cynical, and one who is with a very simple person, positive attitude. And the it of time again. And then towards the end, the person who is with a positive attitude is overpowered with the person who is udas, but later the one who is more simple, he wins. This just he can dance. The poem gets over, but Rohiniji's point is done afterwards. So whatever she did, whatever she created, she used to test it to her norms and use it and choreograph it. So this is the first layer, that is using someone else's choreography, poetry. Then the second is poems made by herself. In this, she didn't leave any aspect of Kathak of Abhinay untouched, like Thumris, Dohas, Pad, Geet, Kirtan, Chaturang, Tara, all kinds, and she added a few. Like, I would like to mention Samadhun Geet, that is, you take a Tarana, and she created poetry to the same tune exactly as of the Tarana, and she used to make us perform them in a pair, that Tarana followed by that Geet, which used to give a very different kind of taste. Another I would like to mention is a Dhrupad. She had created a Dhrupad which was apt for dance, apt for Kathak, and it was unique in every aspect of it. I'm not going to go into details of that, but those lyrics and music again was by her, and it was set to 7.5 beats, and in which she had shown variations in Abhinaya as well as Laikari and everything. So this is about her own poetry. And third, I would like to just mention that she used to write poems for herself, mostly in Marathi. And that is a complete separate compartment. And she used to say that if she was in a stressful situation, then writing a poem used to just wash off her stress. She used to leave off it totally. So this was a process for herself, internal process, with which I remember her calling me sometimes early in the morning that this is what I did today. She would read that poem and said that now I'm free. I'm completely free of those emotions or that stress. So she had this mechanism in herself. So she used poetry in many ways. And I'm going to give you a few examples to be seen through videos also. So the first one is it relates to your question about choice of subject as well as taal. This is the Ardhanari Nateshwar Stotra of Adi Shankaracharya ji.
Okay.
And the music is hers. And when she thought of this, Eddie, if you listen to the lyrics, anybody could use Tishra or Chatushra Jati for it to set the music. It is Champeya Gaurardha Sharira Kaye, Karpura Gaurardha Sharira Kaye, Dhammilla Kaye Ita Jata Dharaya, Namah Shivaya Ita Namah Shivaya. Now, how she thought of this, it is difficult to perceive, but she chose Japtal, Khanda Jati for this, which is like unthinkable. And that tune that she created and this Japtal together, they create such a wonderful texture, they give texture to the music that you just get drawn into that music. And just for this choice of Taal, please observe Japtal in this. Let's see a minute of this piece.
Yeah.
So the other example that I'm going to show you a video of is a poem, but I am going to have that piece explained by her. I will just say that the subject of this is, the treatment is very abstract. The subject is timeless. The subject is time. So the ballet was about time, 15-minute ballet. And we will see a glimpse of it through a little bit of video and a little bit of photographs. And this has music. Somebody had gifted her with this music in Europe. And the name of the music was Fragrant Gardens, made by a Westerner, a musician. And okay. She had listened to the poem separately and the music separately. And how it got created inside her to use the two together, that it seemed like the music was created afterwards for this piece of dance. So please play the video.
Read four lines in Sambho. The time is time as order, time as flow.
Yes.
Time flies, time freezes, time inspires, time teaches. So I took these four lines and added one to it, time is.
Mm-hmm. Time as flow. Time as moments ticking away. Time as order. Time gives rise to the sound of music, patterns of movements, phrases in rhythm. Time stagnates during waiting and pain. Time evaporates during involvement and pleasure. Time inspires. What is time? A friend or a foe? Time is. Time simply is.
You can see that this is just a little bit out of the 15 minutes. And if we start talking about the kind of movements and expression through body movements that she invented through this ballet, is we need an hour to talk about time. So I'll just leave it there and go to another topic. The last video that I want to show of her choreography is a poem, as I said before, from the earliest times of human poetry. So this is Usha Sukta. This is invocation to the goddess of dawn. The idea is that before the sun rises, the goddesses of dawn appear on a chariot and they wake up all the beings, living beings, with two legs or four legs, all of them. And very gently they do this. And then everybody becomes Jagrat. And then they are ready to receive the sun, the god of energy. So the way she decided to use music for this, of course it is hers. Many of her compositions have her own lyrics and own music, as I said before. So the music is with, like the mantra, Mantochar is done with just 3-4 notes. That's how the music is done. And even the gestures are not very formal gestures. They are there, but this was a period when the gesture language was not evolved. So in a very restricted and beautiful way, she depicted this poetry. And towards the end, as Madhuri maybe could be able to explain more, but from Rag Malkans, it goes into Ahir Bhairav when the Gayatri Mantra is sung, when offerings are done to the sun. So also the other things like the lights. The lights used to be specially designed, and towards the end, when it is the sunrise, when the day is breaking, then it used to be warm light. And at the back on the white curtain, there used to be sunrise created with the help of lights, with the rays. So that used to give a very beautiful feel to it. Also, when the goddesses of dawn came on a chariot, that I cannot show you here because good recording is not available. But through Caroline's beautiful pictures, we are going to show Usha Sukta. Even in time, we saw some of her pictures that she clicked herself. So this effect of light, also the costume. So this was a very early period, and how the people would dress up, or the valkalas, that is the from the tree bark, they used to take the, what should you say, and make clothes out of that. So to give that effect, she had chosen very raw kind of linen and specific colors so as to give that feeling of the times. She always said that when you create something, it should have the taste or flair of that era, that region, and that whatever is depicted in the poetry. So let's just see all of that together in Usha Sukta.
Sure. Yeah,
it's her sing, her own singing.
Om Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Prachodayat Diyo Yona Prachodayat Diyo Yona Prachodayat Om Shanti 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 Om
Yeah.
Thank you.
Now I would request Carolyn to tell us about what you feel about the choreography aspect of Rohini.
Thank you. Sometimes it's hard to speak after such compositions. You don't just want to fall in silence. So I see Rohiniji as a true philosopher and a very progressive thinker. And she always had her own approach for traditional classical compositions and also for contemporary choreographies. And starting from classical compositions, she would just not reproduce a repertoire or standard movements or emotions. She once told me when I did the documentary about her that when she dances a composition about Krishna, she doesn't have the statue of Krishna in front of her eye and just wants to dance as the image is. But she said she goes deep inside her and tries to come out again with the spirit of Krishna. And I found this very unique because she, everything she would create was produced out of herself. She would not just take anything and copy it, but it was her own approach, her own thought process, and also trying to feel the spirit of this particular god or item or subject. And in her contemporary choreographies, I was amazed how progressive her approach was on social, political, cultural subjects. And she would make straightforward statements of the status of women or environmental issues or philosophical and very deep spiritual aspects, like we saw time. And so I was amazed for her time, also decades back, how she was thinking. And she was much ahead of her time and even ahead of the time now, as we see about topics of women and diversity. And so when she staged these thoughts and this thought process, it was presented extremely precisely designed and framed like a piece of art or framed like a film image. And she would be extremely thoughtful to complete this perfect image with a foreground, with a background, with a middle ground to expose the dramaturgical meaning of her item. So, but it was always also under the subject. I mean, she would not, in films also, you can create beautiful images, but they're just for the beauty, they're just for the beautiful image they are. So she would not do that. She would always create the image for the purpose of the subject. So it looked always very modern and very ahead of her time. And even she was decades back, she was ahead of our time, I feel. And we still can learn today from her thoughts, which she had like decades ago. So it was, I feel really that she is a guidance, not only for dancers, but also for all artists and all mankind, because her thoughts are so deep and meaningful for our society.
Anything particular you would like to mention about the lighting, about the costumes?
Her lighting, as I, lighting and costumes and framing, as I said before, it's in a kind puristic, but puristic in a way that it it showed the core of the, it was not puristic, not in a sense of simple, but puristic in to focus on the core of the subject and the core of the story she wanted to tell. So as I said, this strong sense for foreground, middle ground and background she created with in space, in time, and also with the stage decor levels and in lighting. And using costumes was not always like fancy, like Nilimaji already said. It was always thoughtful, taken from either the subject, the time, but also to create this total image of colors, stage design, like we see the photos now. It's just perfect in all nuances.
Yeah. Thank you. Abhi, now I would request Madhuri ji to share her experience about the choreography aspects. Madhuri ji, aap bataiye.
इतनी लंबी जर्नी में आज जितने मैं देख रही हूँ क्लिप्स और फोटोग्राफ्स, सबकी मैं साक्षी हूँ, सब में मैं गाई हूँ, और मुझे ये आनंद मिल रहा था कि गाने को मिलना ये एक बात है, लेकिन उसकी जो प्रोसेस होती है, जब कोरियोग्राफी बनती है, सब एटम उसका शुरू रहता है, उसमें मैंने बहुत आनंद लिया था, क्योंकि जब वो आती थी क्लास पे तो मुझे बिल्कुल याद है कि एक एक चीज़ मैं गाने वाली हूँ थोड़ी देर में, लेकिन जब एक एटम कोई भी ये त्रिवेणी मैं गाने वाली हूँ तो उन सब में नृत्य की तरफ से, स्वर की तरफ से, लय की तरफ से, और एज ए सोलो और ग्रुप परफॉर्मेंस जो भी कोरियोग्राफी होती थी उनके मन में वो तय की थी, ऐसे नहीं होता था, यानी उनके मन में म्यूजिक, लय, ताल और पूरी उनकी जो रचना होती थी वो सब बन के ही आती थी। एक उन्होंने मुझे चीज सिखाई थी, त्रिवेणी है वो, तीन ताल में निबद्ध है, तीन ताल, झपताल और रूपक। तो सुनने में पहले तो ऐसे लगा कि ये बहुत कठिन होगी, लेकिन उनकी सोच, उनका म्यूजिक और उन्होंने जो सिखाया, वो अभी हमने जो उषित सुक्त में देखा वो उन्होंने ही गाया था, तो हमें पता चलेगा कि कितनी सुंदर आवाज और सुर की वो पहचान उनको थी। तो ये मैं बता रही हूँ, खमाज राग में है, तीन ताल में निबद्ध है, लेकिन फिर भी वो इतनी मेलेडियस, यानी ना उसके ताल उसको छेदते हैं, ना उसका मूड कभी भी डिस्टर्ब होता है, पूरी रचना खमाज राग में है। तो आज मेरे पास कुछ बाकी म्यूजिशियंस या कोई नहीं है, लेकिन फिर भी गम पधनी सा सानी धा पद गम ग गम पधनी
सा,
इस स्ट्रक्चर में देखिए पहले मैं तीन ताल गाऊंगी और उसके बाद उसकी वर्ड्स गाती हूँ। धा धिन धिन धा धिन धिन धा धा तिन तिन ता ता धिन धिन धा धीना धी धीना धीना धी धीना ते ते ना धीना धीना ना छेड़ो ना छेड़ो ना करो बर जोरे कंकरी मारी पूरी गगरी भीग गए सारी ना छेड़ो ना करो बर जोरे। तो ये तीन ताल इतने आराम से कहते थे और इतनी सुंदर रचना थी जो कभी मुझे कठिन ही नहीं लगी। या तो उन्होंने मारवा की सरगम सिखाई थी, उन्होंने ही रची थी वो, ये भी वर्ड और ये तीन ताल वाली रचना ये भी रोहिणी जी की है। और ये जो दूसरी गा रही हूँ मैं रे रे नी धा मध मग रे 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 ध नी ध मग रे 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 ध नी ध मग रे ध मग रे ध मग रे 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 धा धा नी धा म ग रे ध नी रे ध नी रे ग म ध नी रे ग म ध नी रे ध नी रे ग म ध नी रे ग म ध ध नी ग रे नी ग म ध म नी ग रे नी रे ध ध नी रे रे नी रे रे ग म ध म ध ध नी रे ग म ध रे 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 धा धा नी धा म ग रे 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 धा धा नी धा म ग रे
क्या
तो ये मारवा में थी तो मैं सीखी क्लास पे और घर गई बाद में प्रैक्टिस पे और घर पे फिर से मैंने दोपहर में वो खोल के देखा कि मैं आज क्या सीख के आई हूँ। उस समय एकदम से ये बात समझ आई कि ये पूरी सरगम में चर्च ही नहीं है। तो मारवा की खासियत है कि ऋषभ दैवत को बार बार सामने लाना है। तो और ये बात मैंने उनसे कही कि चर्च नहीं है तो वो बोली अच्छा मेरी समझ नहीं आया था ये। यानी उनके मन में हर रात का जो डिजाइनिंग बनता था वो इतनी प्योरली उनके पास था कि उनको उसके ऊपर सोचने की कुछ जरूरत ही नहीं थी। एक एक त्रिवट था धान 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 धा तिरक टिटिकत गति घन धाति धाधा धाति धाकड़ा धान 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 धा। तो ये बिहागड़ा करके राग है लेकिन उनके मन में जो नोट्स आए उसके ऊपर उन्होंने त्रिवट बांध दिया और दूसरे दिन मुझसे पूछा माधुरी ये राग कौन सा है। तो उनका ये जो म्यूजिकली तैयार भी होना और इनोसेंस एक तरीके का ये इतना प्यारा था। लेकिन बहुत सारी रचनाएं मैंने जितनी भी रचनाएं उनसे सीखी उन सब में ताल की तरफ से तो कुछ ट्विस्ट होता था स्वर की तरफ से लेकिन कभी भी ऐसा नहीं कर देते थे कि ये सुनने में बहुत कठिन लग रहा है ये कैसे होगा। ये होता ही नहीं था क्योंकि वो म्यूजिक और डांस और वो लय और ताल सब इतने एक के एक हाथ में हाथ डाल के जाते थे कि कभी कोई तकलीफ ही नहीं हुई और वो बहुत सुंदर लगता था। एक दिखाने वाले हैं आप शायद सिंदूर वदना तो उसके एक अंतरे में दीन बजत सुनी नादत गंभीर मंत्र अरुतार मधुर सुर ऐसी रचना जाती है उसकी। तो उस म्यूजिक में भी मंद्र मध्य और तार सब तक आ गए मंद्र अरुतार मधुर सुर प गम प गम रे सा प ध प गम प रे सा प ग म रे सा प ध प ग म प ग म रे सा ग म प ग म रे सा ग म प ग म रे सा सा रे रे ग ग म म सिंधूर। आलाप में भी तीनों शब्द और अंतरे में भी तीनों शब्द शायद अभी उसमें से थोड़ा सा निकल गया लेकिन ये तो बात है जो जिसके पास ये नॉलेज है उसी को ये पॉसिबल है। घर में बैठे कोई तो भी नहीं हो सकता ऐसी बातें वो बनाती थी और इनके ऊपर जो कोरियोग्राफी बनती थी वो तो देखते देखते हम अचंभित हो जाते थे क्योंकि वो म्यूजिक के साथ इतनी जुड़ जाती थी कि एक बार तो उन्होंने कहा था कि हम दोनों का ऐसे ट्यून हुआ था कि मैं उसके पहले डांस के साथ कभी गाई नहीं थी। उनके बुलाने पर मैं जब गई तो दैट वॉज फर्स्ट टाइम इन माई लाइफ। तो मैं गई तो उसके बाद वो सिलसिला 25 साल चलता रहा। इतने हम एक दूसरे से जुड़ गए। एक इंटरव्यू में उन्होंने बोला कि हमारा ट्यूनिंग इतना हो गया है कि वो डांस करके और मैं गाती
क्या बात तो हम ये वीडियो देखते हैं।
Yeah.
Now I would request Hasita ji to share her views on the choreography aspects and as a guru.
Okay. So as Rijita mentioned that her creative aspect is so wide, so it's hard to choose which one to pick. So I'm just going to pick again Sindura Vadana, and you have seen the video also. So I think Sindura Vadana is very complete choreography, and complete in a sense that she wrote the lyrics, she gave music, and she choreographed. So everything is hers. That aspect is, I'm saying, complete. And in other way, that it has, like when you make a choreography, you draw from all the gifts and all the skills you have cultivated. So Rohini ji's skills is so profound and so strong. So she has Sanskrit, Marathi, poetry, rhythm, dance, music, everything together. And so this Sindura Vadana is very complete choreography. And once I was thinking, and it is so coincidence or real, I don't know, but I was thinking that in shloka, many times, say, for example, if it is about Krishna, we would say Govardhan Dhari. And so people, whether they know who's Govardhan Dhari or I would say the story aspect, we don't elaborate on it. So I was thinking that the choreography should be like that, that you say the object, adjective, and then elaborate on this. And when I went to India and I saw this, and I thought, wow, this is like Murta Swaroop of what I was thinking. And so Sindura Vadana, if you see that, it begins very meditative way. It describes the Ganesh, its decoration, and many novel decoration that to the tusks, you know, she is decorating, or the ears, there are mala. So there are three stanzas, and it's very clear, clean cut that from very serene beginning, then there is, it goes in Atgun. Then again, it comes to that serene meditative lyrics. And the things woven, like I would read the stanza, which is my favorite. So, Umrudanga Vadana Vivida Bhati Ati Lalita Alankrita Nritya Manohara. So, Mridanga Vadana, so very masculine folk or rustic movements it has. And it shows how many different ways, and she does it so beautifully in movement. So with Taal and with Taal, she visualizes whatever the bowl is, exactly she visualizes the movement and she choreographs. Then the next line, Lalita Alankrita Nritya Manohar. So in contrast to that masculine, she comes to feminine movement, very feminine movement, and comes up with the that kind of movement, and then Toda going to that. So I thought that was very beautifully how she is drawing so many elements into one choreography, and at the end, very meditative footwork she stops with. So I really like, and it is like I have performed, and I'm thankful to Nilima and Asavari because I learned this choreography after she passed away, and I didn't have a fortune to perform in front of her. But in USA, I have performed so many times in front of blacks and whites and browns and different genders and different age groups, and it is taken as like a choreography which crosses all the boundaries. There are so many, it has rhythm, it has beautiful movement, it has that spiritual meaning to it. So that way it is, I think if it is very true, it goes across. So that I would like to talk about Sindhura Vadana. Thank you. I don't hear. I was supposed to recite the Doha. Yeah, so this is in reference to what she gave me as a guru.
Yeah.
So I think she just teach me, or none of us, like teach the movement or just dance, but the whole life. So as she was larger than life, and she wanted us also to be larger than life. As her father always used to tell, that light another life. And that was the vision she gave us. And so that impact was more when it was one-to-one interaction. And as a guru, Like I'm out of Pune now for 30 years, and I wondered that every day I think of her, I have dialogue with her, she guides me, she gives me ideas. So what is that connection? And I was thinking back, and I want to share this experience, my experience with you, that she showed me that this art has potential to lift you up. And if you follow the very meticulous mantra that work hard and work without intentions, work without any agenda, and go for ultimate truth. And that truth is like you will get it. There is no doubt about it. So in that reference, I was performing this Doha, and she taught me Thumri Yaad Piya Ki Aai. And before that, this Doha comes. So the wording is Chakai Bichudi Rehn Ki Aai Mili Parbhat Jo Jana Bichude Piyaso Na Sukha Deena Rati. So as Madhuri was mentioning that when she comes for the session, she is full of those vibrations in her already. So Yadapi Aki Aai Bahut Kanthita, she very briefly explained me that here is the small girl, like 12 years old, she got married, and then here at her husband's house, she hasn't created any relations yet. She has no experience of life. And so bring that mental set in you and let's begin. And because she has whole theme, whole subject, whole choreography, everything in her mind already, she just says few sentences and you get that. And so she started singing Chakai Bichudi Rainaki. And the next thing I remember that we were in some other lok. And she finished the whole stanza. She's saying that Chakravak Chakravaki, who are lovebirds, they are cursed that they will be separated from each other during the night. And she hears that whole cry of separation. And this Naika is thinking that, okay, in the morning, they fly with happiness. But me, day and night, both are same. Because I don't know when my beloved is going to come. And that whole subject she taught me was so intense. And the next thing I remember that she said, okay, Hasita, let's stop today. And she was in the couch next to her Deccan Gymkhana class, next to the phone of our class. And I remember that coming back to reality was so torturous. So that experience of upliftment and dance still today I carry with me. And what she told me, that just work, 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 without any agenda, without any intention. And so life has ups and downs, but this art is more than life. And that's what she told me, taught me. So I think she was more than, way more than, rather than guru. And I'm fortunate to have that gift from her.
Amazing, amazing. So now we would like to see a video of Rohini ji with students. मैं वो वीडियो जरा एक बार प्ले करता हूँ
Yeah.
हाँ जी, हम चाहेंगे कि आप कुछ बताएं रोहिणी जी के बारे में एज अ गुरु स्टूडेंट्स के साथ, उनका समय, आप सबका समय।
मैं तो पहले तो ये बताना चाहूंगी कि आई डोंट कम फ्रॉम अ म्यूजिशियन और डांसर्स फैमिली। आई गॉट इनटू डांस जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ रोहिणी जी। शी वाज अ रोल मॉडल फॉर अस। She was the one who inspired everybody to take dance as a career. And at one time, it was more because I wanted to be with her than dance. So she inspired each and everyone around her. Other thing I would like to tell you is she was a very generous guru. At that time, I remember that not many people could see the riyas of their gurus. I was fortunate. I would see her riyas every day. She would teach us everything she wanted. I remember that if we couldn't get something, she would think about it the whole rest of the day. The next day she would come out with the solution. So that's another thing. And the last thing I would say is she taught us the values, not just the technique, not just the toda tukda paran, but the values, the principles. So it was like I'm using her own expression, it was like giving key. So you open the door and look into the world of dance yourself. So she was a person who would encourage people to see dance, to feel dance. And to quest, she developed the quest for dance in all of us, she taught. Thank you.
क्या बात है? To feel the dance is something बहुत ही important जो आपने कहा. And now मैं माधुरी जी से request करूँगा, वो कुछ बात कहें.
मैं गई तो थी उनके पास कि जब डांस के साथ गाना है ये समझा के, तो आई वॉज वेरी टेंस क्योंकि मुझे पता नहीं था कि ये कैसे गाया जाता है, कौन सी बंदिशें okay. होती है. आई वॉज अ क्लासिकल सिंगर. हाँ, तो पहले तो मुझे बहुत उसका तनाव लगा, लेकिन जैसे जैसे मैं उनकी बंदिशों के साथ जुड़ती गई, मानो उन घुंघरुओं का और मेरे सुरों का एक नाता हो गया. और बहुत अच्छी बातें, यानी ऐसे मुझे तो सिर्फ चंद्रकांत का एक नगमा कथक के साथ बजता है, इतना ही म्यूजिकली जानती थी मैं. लेकिन इतनी सुंदर और रिच कॉम्पोजिशंस उनके पास मुझे सीखने को मिली, ये मेरा सौभाग्य है बहुत ही. और वो सुर के लिए बहुत ही आग्रही थी, और भगवान की देन से मैं सुरीली थी तो हमारा बहुत सुंदर तरीके से वो जर्नी चलता गया. लेकिन उनके पास जाने से मैंने शब्दों के उच्चार कैसे हो, संस्कृत ब्रज और अवधी भाषा में और हिंदी भाषा में सब रचनाएं होती थी, वो कैसी गानी चाहिए, उसके लिए उच्चारण कैसे होना चाहिए, या तो पहले नीलिमा ने रेफर किया था समधुन, तो एक लाइन सिर्फ मैं गाती हूँ. देरे ना देरे ना देरे ना देरे ना देर 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 दानी तड़ियाने, ये बागेश्वरी का तराना था. और लगन लगे मगन भई में जिया सुख पाए, सेम नोटेशन, और वो बोलते हैं समधुन. तो ऐसी रचनाएं मुझे नहीं लगता कि अगर मैं सिर्फ क्लासिकल गाती रहती तो ये मेरे परिचित हो जाती है और मुझे पता चलता. दूसरी बात, बामाणा द्रुपद उन्होंने सिखाया था, और इन सब की पहचान मुझे वहीं पे होती रही. उनके गुरु पहले नीलिमा ने बताए थे, उन सब से उन्होंने जो सीखा वो सब उनके म्यूजिक में रिफ्लेक्ट होता था और वो मुझे मिलता गया. बिल्कुल एक एक लाइन में मैं बताती हूँ. एक दोहा गाती थी, बाजी घर आई, इसमें मुझे इतना वसंत राव जी का इम्प्रेशन लगता था बाजी देख बे कोठाई बाजी मुरझाई तो बाजी घर आई। ये जो डेकोरेशन है बाजी देख बे कोठाई, ये जो जलत ताने थी छोटी छोटी टप्पे जैसे, वो मुझे लगता है शायद वसंतराव जी से उन्होंने पाई। या तो मारवा सरगम जो मैंने अभी गाई जिसमें शरद जी का प्रयोग नहीं था, तो जो रामकृष्ण जी से रामकृष्ण जोशी जी से उन्होंने सीखा जिसमें उन्होंने संगीत विशारद किया था, वो बहुत बहुत स्टडी थी और उनकी नोटबुक उन्होंने मुझे दी है, उसमें उनकी नोट्स इतनी सुंदर है कि राग की तरफ या गाने की बंदिश की तरफ वो कैसे देखती थी वो मुझे पता चलता है अभी कि उन नोटबुक ने क्या क्या दिया मुझे। और दूसरे गुरु बोले थे केशवराव भोले जी जो महाराष्ट्रीय थे, तो एक वंदना करती है ये सब डांसर्स।
फुलेंदीवर कांति मिंदु वदनम,
ये जो एक्सटेंशन है बरहावतम सप्रियम श्रीवत्सांकमुदार कौस्तुभधरम पीतांबरम सुंदरम। ये मुझे लगता है कि जो केशवराव भोले जी उनके तीसरे गुरु थे उनसे ये उन्होंने लिया होगा, और वो तो अपने आप में संपूर्ण ही थी क्योंकि सब म्यूजिक लेके ही उनके मन में वर्ड्स आते थे, लय और म्यूजिक लेके ही। तो ये सब बातें मुझे उनसे सीखने को मिली, ये मेरा सौभाग्य है ना कि और जो मेरा ज्ञान था क्लासिकल म्यूजिक का उसको उससे बहुत मुझे बढ़िया बातें सीखने को मिली, और जिसका मुझे मेरी महफिल में भी बहुत उपयोग करने का भाग्य मिला। तो एज अ मैं सिंगर होते हुए भी वो मेरी हाँ। बहुत गुरु रही है डांसर होते हुए।
थैंक यू कैरोलिन जी। नाउ वी वुड लाइक टू नो फ्रॉम यू एज अ गुरु एंड see that spiritual philosophical approach and how you know in a foreign land so many people have taken up to this. Can you tell us something on this?
Yes, so for me it was extremely interesting and challenging but also a lifetime experience to receive this art from Rohini ji, which was not of my own cultural or spiritual religious background. And I have been to India 25 times, but I'm an outsider. So, but being an outsider has one advantage, that you can't take anything for granted or any gesture for granted. I had to learn every gesture, every feeling, every expression, and every word anew. So I need to completely process it completely new in my body. And it helped me so much to have Rohini ji as a guru who is such a perfectionist. So she would not be satisfied till you do something completely precisely correct. And but this really helped me to be groomed in the art and to really learn very slowly and to have a complete process. If I relate to Sindhura Vadana, which was also a composition that's totally wrapped my mind when Ruchita and Shavari, and I saw them learning it in Pune, and I used to sit in the morning session every day. And I asked her once if I could learn it. I think it was the only time I once asked her if I could learn an item because I was so enthralled by it. And she said, yeah, then you have to come to India for 6 months. So that was her, how she saw how you should learn. I mean, that precisely and that slow. And but that helped me to really be molded by her. And then it was very interesting to give that art onwards in the West. And I'm very fortunate to have students who stay with me for a very long time. That's, I think, very unusual. And I'm very, very proud and very happy about them. But teaching them, I never force them to adapt to a new religion. I cannot, and a new belief system. But with Ruhiniji's deep approach towards life and towards spirituality, I feel that the compositions bring the students gradually to a deeper experience or a deeper sense of life or God, whatever you believe in. So when we rehearsed Bole Shiva for a performance, which we had received from Nilima Ji in a workshop, I wasn't sure in the beginning if the students were able to go beyond the form and to reach the point or reach the depths of a composition where you really can feel the grandness or the depths of Shiva. And but they rehearsed so hard, and I told them frankly, I'm not such a strict guru, but then I was strict and I said, you're only being able to perform it if you can go beyond the form and really feel it, come to this deep point which Ruhiniji has created for us. But then they started to rehearse so hard and so intense. And in the final rehearsal, I said, okay, I saw that expression on their face, which was so reverent and so elated. And well, I said, okay, that's all good. It's a miracle. So I feel that Ruhiniji's composition bring you to that higher level of yourself in this higher level of life. So yeah, I brought a small clip of that performance.
Yeah, we will see the clip also. Yeah. Carol, we can see the intensity with which you and your students are working. It's really very, very enriching and beautiful to know about this. Now I will, yeah, tell them.
Yeah, they actually they just want to go on learning Bole Shiva the whole time, so they don't want to do anything else because they are so. So I feel, but I feel if this spark comes across to you that you receive from the community, I think you can't stop anymore. And it's good to see the spark going further.
Yeah, nice. So now I would like to ask Rujita Ji to tell us about Ruhiniji as a guru.
I really have no words. Carolyn, really amazing performance by you, and we have seen you learning in Pune, and you used to travel with us everywhere where we used to go. And I still remember the journey to Calcutta, how we traveled. Really, it was amazing experience to be with you and discuss with you every time about Bebitai and her spirituality and how she used to like think about each and every composition as a complete composition, you know. Like Hasita Tai mentioned about the Sindura Vadana, how the composition was complete in itself. When I started learning directly from Bebitai, I remember I learned directly a very advanced level Taal, that is an odd number, 7.5 beats Taal Neel. And I have been like performing that for so many years. I hardly performed Teen Taal, but I performed Saade Saat Matra a lot. And she made the odd number Taals as a complete repertoire of Kathak. So like Sindura Vadana, I would like to mention here, she composed a Dhrupad in praise of Lord Ganesha. So that is as a Vandana in Saade Saat Matra. Then, of course, a Taal ranging from Vilambit, Madhya to Dhruta, and to end up with a Samadhun Rachana, Madhuri Tai mentioned. The Samadhun Rachana was composed in Saade Saat Matra, the Tarana with the Abhinayi. So, we always have learned how to think about the composition, and whenever we try to choreograph or we try to compose any sequence, how we should think about it and to take it to the completeness. It's really very difficult because we have so many things received from Bebitai which are complete in itself, and digesting them and presenting them again and again, it's a really a riyaz for us always. And I don't know, she had some kind of a magnetic power which always kept all of us bound together. And she never had barriers between dance and herself. And she showered a similar impact on us by always making us realize that never keep yourself and your passion separate. She never asked us to appear for any exams, but as for us dancing in front of her, doing riyas, itself an examination we would appear for every day. And she developed her own style, and she gave us as well the vision to explore our own style with continuous riyas, contemplation of thinking and creating one's own identity, own style, and own personality. And I can see and I can experience in all my senior Guru Bhaginis and even my colleagues who are following that discipline, that principles, and have created distinctive personalities. So really, she has been really encouraging for us, and really amazing personality, a multifaceted personality. And I think usme se ek bhi hum gun le le, or if we can present ek bhi perfectly, so it would be really a blessing for us. Matlab bahut bahut itna kaam kiya hai, the words are really very limited, and really I really don't have any words say about her. She's a perfect guru, perfect mother, perfect parent for us always. Thank you.
Very well said, Rajita ji. And ab main Neelima ji se request karunga ki ve hame bataye aapka samay रोहिणी जी के साथ और एज अ गुरु आप शेयर कीजिए आपके थॉट्स।
ऐसा है कि व्हाटएवर आई से इट अप्लाइज टू एवरी वन ऑफ अस एक्चुअली, सो आई वुड से दैट शी ग्रूम्ड ऑल ऑफ अस प्रैक्टिकली इन एवरी एस्पेक्ट ऑफ लाइफ। एंड इफ आई से अबाउट मी, आई थिंक शी गेव टू माई बीइंग और टू माई वेरी कोर अ लैंग्वेज फॉर एक्सप्रेशन विच इज अ बिग थिंग टू हैपन। She showered and nurtured me with limitless knowledge and her limitless repertoire. She exhibited what sadhana is, what creativity is. It is really difficult to catch in words. Her sadhana was, I mean, what sadhana can do is, hello? So it is not just the talent, but it has to be accompanied by sadhana. You just have to keep doing. Then she taught me to be genuine. This virtue is so important. And she also taught us that you should make dance your way of life. Whatever you are doing in 24 hours, dance should be at the bottom of your mind and you should not leave that thought even for a minute. So dance should be your way of life. She showed us the way to work, to live, by giving us a mantra. The mantra was Janije Yajna Karma in Marathi. Or you can say that Apna kaam karte hue use yajna karma maniye. Or for the self, selflessly you have to work. So this was the motto of our institute has been, and that she gave to everybody. I would say that I'm extremely fortunate to have experienced a guru-shishya relation, which in Indian culture is supposed to be probably the most precious, and that too with a guru like her. So I'm really short of words, and I would just say that Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha on behalf of all of us.
So as we come to the closing of this program, which you know, we have been remembering Vidushi Rohini Bhatteji, I would like to thank each one of you by name: Madhuri ji, Shama ji, Neelima ji, Rujita ji, Hasita ji, and Caroline, for having come and shared your experiences in this difficult moments, and you know, you have explained to the whole world which is seeing this program and listening it, so many wonderful moments that you have experienced with the great guru, the one and only Vidushi Rohini Bhatteji. And I know so much effort has gone into this. Neelima ji has archived, collected so many videos, photographs, each one of you. And Shama ji ne to ekdam sama bandha hai sabke saath, aur she has brought everyone together here on this platform. So I would like to thank all of you on behalf of all the you know, the viewers and all the listeners who have got an opportunity at this moment to, you know, experience these moments. So I would now show the video of Vidushi Rohini Bhatteji, with which we will be closing the program.
And I just want to say one small thing.
Yeah.
The small thing that you don't know what even all of us with this evening, that we could together sit and think about Rohini ji and speak about her, has been a wonderful time for all of us. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Dekhna sakyo devaki ko dukh, dekhna sakyo devaki ko dukh, dekhna sakyo devaki ko dukh, प्रगट भए बनवारी प्रगट भए
प्रगट भए प्रगट भए
प्रगट भए बनवारी प्रगट भए बनवारी प्रगट भए प्रगट भए बनवारी प्रगट भए बनवारी प्रगट भए बनवारी प्रगट भए बनवारी प्रगट भए प्रगट भए बनवारी प्रगट भए बनवारी प्रगट भए बनवारी मुष्टिक अरु चाणूर कुवलिया
नमस्कार थैंक यू